So, since it is our last concert here in Athens, we wanted to prepare something special. And since it is the last day of connection with Castle, I think they can probably hear us. We wanted to create the biggest harmony possible between this room and the room in Castle. So, if you can, please stand up. And let's all move towards the computer. The closer, the better. You can leave your bags wherever you want.
Yeah, I'm I guess for me, I think it's possible to see if we can imagine something like that. It's very beautiful. You want to start, Ahmed?
Yes.
Thank you. Oh! cultural capital.
Thank you. the performance to see? Yes, we have to see the way the other things are going. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Are you leaving?
Yes, we're going.
Can you leave us a small feedback?
Can you leave us a small feedback? I mean, considering what is happening here, how do you feel now?
It was kind of a fun mirroring effect.
Yeah.
Get troubled about the relationship of the ego with our, or with we, I with we, when you give the definition of the social paraphony. Help so that the social subject is emerged.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Yeah.
Paraphony.
Somewhat escalated quickly. Monosyphis.
After 4 years of doing, 4 months of doing this, it's incredible to see how the crowd makes the show. There's never been one concert that we actually came up with an idea and went all the way the way we planned in our heads. That doesn't exist. The Documenta phenomenon in Athens has also been very interesting to me. It was an organization with every Greek symptom that we could find. It was interesting. I don't know now that it's ending for Athens, what Athens has learned, what Castle has learned from us, from Documenta in general. I guess that's the point. I don't know how many people have come and go in this room, throughout this from Naples, when they went out to their real lives, how much of what happened in this room, interesting or not interesting, fun or not fun, how much of that managed to survive in the real world instead of the art room and art gallery where you can be safe, to be stupid, to be free.
Okay, maybe the thing that I enjoyed the first part of this increasing of doing music as a noise with the group and also with casting and to play and have fun. And then this moment when, as you said, we're in the past, it's easier when you know more or less what is expected or for flowing with a mass, and then the cuts that in between that you don't want to follow, or for me, even the thing that it was in an art project, I don't know if it makes you feel more free or more, I don't know how to say it, efficient or something like this that I didn't know how I expected to
self-conscious maybe.
I don't know, some things up for me. At least it was very interesting to see in the beginning that everyone was pretty shy to start. And didn't know how to follow the others. And I think that in the beginning we all tried to follow the same kind of tempo, the kindness and note, yes, exactly. We tried to be as similar as possible. But then you could see that, okay, some people weren't, you know, that low with their key. And so they had to go higher and you could see many different voices.
Yeah.
And then someone would be like, fuck it, I'm going to try something different.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
And also, there's a moment that I think that, okay.
We are trying to do these cantics with one note and then, harmonicos?
Yes.
And I thought that maybe we could do this as a group. Finally, I realized that maybe not. So
we faked
it. And for me, I also had in mind a lot of time, especially in the beginning, that something must be scripted. You know, something there should be like a guidance, a route we should take, and not diverge from that. But I saw that as I was going, there is no route. It's just do it as you feel it, and there is no clear guideline.
Yeah.
You make it as you go.
So in the beginning, we said that the idea for today was to connect with Castle and create a very harmonious effect, and this is why we proposed the idea of the simultaneous singing. And I'm wondering to what extent did we connect to Castle and how
that's always happened, the connection with gospel, or today? Okay. For me, it was really really interesting at the moment that we started writing. The thing that maybe there are part in here of them, we don't know what happened. And this tension about they are laughing at playing a concert, or is there something that happened that we don't know, so they don't laugh. And for me, it was really, really interesting. And also, we didn't know what happened. No, the moment that they approached, it was like, yeah, okay, maybe we do that. It's really interesting. You know? And at the moment the connection stopped, it was really hard. What happened? We are alone, and we didn't know how to continue. And it's really awful, and for me, it was like hard to continue.
It's like we lost half of the people here.
Yeah, sure. But when the people from here go, we know that they go because they want. But that's the most like.
I'm gonna be the one who's gonna be exploring and fixing everything. And I have to, I don't know, it feels like some kind of therapy. I'm getting hot and disappointed, but it feels some kind of therapy, fake therapy. I didn't find any connection. No, there was some connection, but not. The kind I expected and credit was taken. And in general, the human was not someone from the person. Which also, I'm sorry.
And now, for me, part about the connection was a mixed feelings in the way that. On one side, you can see that there's people who are also having fun, they were also expressing themselves, and that gave you a more humane, you know, way of looking at them. Like, okay, these are also human beings that have a sense of humor, they can let go when it matters and the source. But I was also, you know, having this kind of reservation, like, how much of this is scripted, and how much is like really spontaneous, how much of this can I do really, because it's another thing when you talk about the person who on screen, and even on the same room, you're not sure how much of this is spontaneous, how much of this is like scripted. I think it's pretty hard to let go of your remorse, suspicious, and thinking all the time aside. It's not something we've learned to do.
Yeah, and also if we are on the same conditions here or in Castle, it was like, okay, this is a room closed. Or just cursed by, for me was also like suspicious. I have fun.
You take one
thing. Everybody tries to do something reasonable. We all want to do it like that. Again, sometimes we can have that with them.
Yeah.
Some things of what he was saying, we perceived that very
painting things that are totally weird and different. Like you see a homeless man on the street and you're feeling too awkward to bother, so you just erase him from your viewpoint. But for me, this time it wasn't this. It was mostly at least in my case. I was like, okay, first, I think this is a girl. Second, I think this is scripted. So third, I'm not gonna really bother about this. Okay, I think it's something that's supposed to, you know, stir us in some kind of direction. For me, it didn't really change that much, the whole thing. So I didn't have anything strong to say about it.
Does anyone have something strong to say about synthesis,
or anyone have some comment on this?
I thought
there was
something to me,
It was scripted. So it was scripted.
Well, there is a general idea. It is not scripted in the way that, because it cannot be scripted, because every person is different. So with a different group of people, this thing will be totally different.
Yeah.
But Sifis wasn't part of the performance.
It
was an individual.
Yeah.
Completely alone.
Yeah. But you know her?
I'm sorry?
Do you know her before?
No, she does.
You know
her? Yeah, yeah, it's a friend of mine. I didn't know she was
a friend. Guys! But
actually, she put some technology in that it creates a kind of mass against somebody's performance, videos of the bad guys, or see, let her do her thing. Mm-hmm. When she's out of the room, you have to start thinking, then what do you do? With the technology, it's the same thing. As soon as it disappears, you kind of realize, oh, these people are gone. Now, what do we need? Or do we have to create? Nobody's watching us. It's very similar to what you do.
Also, I wanted to comment on the fact that what Sifis was saying was a kind of a critique about what he was saying was that during the moment I refused to exoticize myself to increase your culture of capital. And this again is a big statement that I felt it should have been addressed somehow. Still, there is a very strong critique that we do not take into account, or we seem to not take into account.
Yeah. But I thought that his intervention clarified the team nature of our collective identity during the performance, in the sense that we were a unified group, sort of, trying to create these harmonies. And I felt very strongly when he started doing this thing that it was our job as a team to sort of create a frame for him. You know, that we were suddenly his backup singers for whatever, 5 minutes. And then he exited the scene, and then we kind of fell back into this other group identity. Only it seemed that after he was finished, our identity was a little bit more cohesive. Somehow. And that made me think about, you know, why did I think we were in competition with Castle? But I did. At a certain point I thought, oh, we're much more interesting. You know, we're on this side doing spontaneous, unexpected things. And they're looking at us thinking, that's a little exotic, isn't it? So I felt that we kind of came together as a group in a very odd way when it suddenly we didn't know what was going to happen next.
I'm